Welcome to iClicker Cloud, the instructor platform that makes it easy to run polling and quizzing sessions, manage grades, and track student attendance. In this video, I'll show you how to run polling sessions in class. Before coming to this step, you'll need to create an account, a class, and download the right iClicker Cloud desktop software. Let's get started. You have two options when you start a polling session. Option number one, launch your polling session from the instructor website. First, you'll need to log into your instructor account. Then click on the course you want to run a polling session in. Click Start Class. Then click Start Poll. This will launch your desktop software. Your second option is to launch your polling session from the desktop software. Sign in to your iClicker Cloud desktop software, and then select the course that you would like to use for your polling session. Next, click Start Polling Session. This will open the master toolbar. You can move it around and place it where you like, and you can make it smaller or larger, depending on how much of the master toolbar you want to see. Instruct students to join your course. The active session icon at the bottom of the master toolbar indicates that your polling session is active and ready to join. The number of students who have joined your active session appears in the master toolbar next to attendees. Please note, if you start a class session from the instructor website prior to opening a poll, your students will be prompted to join class and then will wait for your poll to begin. You'll need to prepare some questions for your students to answer. iClicker works with any presentation software that you'd like to use, and you do not need to preload questions and answers into the system, making it a polling system that works along with your lesson plan, giving you the freedom to skip questions or add questions as the course dictates. Once you have a question ready, click Polling. Move the toolbar to where you like it, and then make sure that the drop-down menu is set to the appropriate polling question choice. You can choose between multiple choice, short answer, numeric, and target questions. On the polling toolbar, click the play button to start the poll. The polling toolbar will show you how much time has elapsed in a poll and how many students have submitted responses. When you're satisfied with the number of students who have responded, click Stop. Let's try another kind of polling question. This is an example of a short answer question. Go to the drop-down menu, click Short Answer, and then click the play button again. Each time you click this play button, it takes a screenshot of whatever you're displaying to your students. So make sure that you're sending your students the view you want them to see. The play button works almost like a camera shutter icon. Again, you'll be able to see the time that's passed on the poll, and you'll be able to see how many students have responded. When you're satisfied with the number of students who've responded, again, click the Stop button. You can also ask your students a numeric question. Simply go up to the menu, change it to numeric, and then again, hit the play button. Students can respond with up to 8 digits. And again, you simply click the Stop button to stop the poll. You can also ask your students a target question. Simply select it from the drop-down menu and then hit play. With a target question, your students will touch a section of the screen to indicate where their answer is. Then they need to click send and you'll see how many answers you've received. Let's press stop. Lastly, you can ask your students anonymous questions. Simply select the type of question it is, then click the hamburger menu to the right and select anonymous. You can see that your toolbar changes to indicate that this is an anonymous question. These questions are truly anonymous. There is no way to go back and figure out what student said what, so make sure that you really know your audience before asking this type of a question. Click the play button, and then your students can respond. Click the stop button to stop the poll. To turn off the anonymous function, go back to the hamburger menu and unclick Anonymous, and you'll see that your poll goes back to white. If you'd like to display your results or grade questions during class, click on Results in the Master Toolbar. This will bring up all of the questions that you asked during that session. In order to grade a multiple choice question, simply click on the correct answer. You can indicate that multiple answers are correct if you want to. To grade a short answer question, you can click on the tick box next to the correct answer. You can also go below and enter your own answer here. And then you can indicate that it's correct by clicking the little box here. You can also indicate which short answer is the best response by clicking on this star and turning it blue. This is an important step to take as the instructor if none of your students have entered an ideal answer to a question. Putting your answer here and then clicking to indicate that it is both correct and the best answer will load it into your students' iClicker Reef accounts, so when they go to study these questions later, they're going to have the best answer in their accounts. You can also view responses as a word cloud. Obviously, this works better when you have more than one student. To grade a numeric response, the process is the same as with a short answer. Simply click the ones that you think are correct. You can select all if you have a big batch of them and you want to give everyone credit. You can also unselect. And you can again add that other response. There's only one response that you indicate is correct. It will also be automatically marked as the best response. To grade a target question, float your mouse over the image, and you'll see it prompts you to grade responses. Click on it. You get a nice big picture of the question that you asked, making it really easy to grade accurately. And then you simply click and drag to create a box around the correct response. When you're happy with your box, click Save. And you'll see that automatically grades all of the responses really easily. Lastly, with an anonymous question, you cannot indicate a correct or incorrect response. This would make it so that you could use the gradebook to trace back who said what in an anonymous poll, and that would defeat the purpose. So make sure that you only ask anonymous questions when you do not need to provide a correct response and when there's nothing sensitive that you would need to trace back to a particular student. When you're done asking your polling questions, you can X out of your results. You can close your floating toolbar, and then you can X out of the master toolbar. At this point, you'll be asked whether or not you want to simply end your session, or if you click the button incorrectly, you can select not to end your session. Or you can end your session with an exit poll. If you end your session with an exit poll, your students will be asked to rate their understanding of your day's class, and they have a small section where they can send you a message if they have any particular questions about your class that day. And then you'll be kicked back to the main menu of the iClicker Cloud desktop software. To learn more about running polls with iClicker Cloud, visit the iClicker support site and search for polling. Thanks for watching!